fact that the Lorain County Wrestling Coaches Association was started 5 years ago by a gentleman by the name of Frank Fiore. And I'm sure most of you know that Mr. Fiore passed away on Thursday evening, Friday morning. And he's the real reason that all of us are here today. Without him, Lorain County Wrestling, the city of Elyria, and a lot of wrestling in the state of Ohio wouldn't be where it is today. And that's really why we're here. So I think it'd be appropriate at this time, we can take just a minute, a moment of silence, in memory of Frank Fiore. Okay, at this time we'd also like to thank Mr. Hata, Rocky's former coach at Oakland High School. He's now at Ravenna, and Rocky's at the Olympic Games, and a lot of help. Dave's through the Olympics, coached a little bit. Sort of as a favor to Rocky, Dave Schultz is here with us today. Help is really much of an introduction. 1983 world champion, 1984 Olympic gold medalist, Dave Schultz.
Yes.
Okay, good. Well, what I'm going to have you guys do every time that I have a break is come everybody on the same side of me in here and as compact as we can get so that everybody can see. The reason that I do this is so that everybody, and in this case, luckily they got a good setup of video equipment too, can all see exactly what I want to show you. In other words, if I want to show you what this arm does, I'm going to show you this side. That in mind, when we call you back in next time, I want you all to just be right in this side. I'll be showing when you break. I'll be organizing cool groups when you hear your friends yell break. It'll be time to come back. What I do is I try to keep small segments of the move at a time. I try to build on what I'm teaching, and I don't cover a whole lot of material. I'm not here to impress anybody with what I know. I'm going to start this morning with a turn of the mat. I guess in Ohio, it's still quite a bit. So I'm going to try to help those of you who already know a tilt, or those who are already up, and those of you who don't, and those of you who hopefully get to where you can do a little bit better. Now, this is a real easy type thing. I'm going to say something to you about saying anything about that. Whenever you're working out, like if we're going to start on our feet this morning, I have to do a good one. That would be easy on the chair when we start out here. We're all cold, black, and it's perfect morning in my time. Yeah, I knew you were doing that. But it'd be easy when you start out, don't crank each other's wrists and whatnot, and we warm up slowly. Generally, though, I always start out with a good warm up, trying to warm up the other joints of the body. Now, on a hip dip, how many of you know this? Do you know what I'm talking about? How do you know this technique? Where you go here and put the knife in there. A few more? Okay. Now, here's what you're really doing on this. You're really doing is you're turning the guy's hips here. Okay? You elevate this leg this way, and that rocks into his back right there. That's all it is. Okay, you turn the hips, you're elevating the lower leg, and that puts them on the back. Now, the way I turn the hips is generally with my arms. The way I do it is by wrapping my arms around his waist. here. Then I'll actually trap, turn his hips here, not by doing this with my arm, but by driving with my foot here. See that? It's just like a little tight grip. My arm is just deep here, and I'm just driving with my chest. Now from here, I sit under, right here. See how far back I am on it? My knees up right between his legs, and I'm just elevating. I push my body away from it. They can say, most people make it. They stay right parallel with the guy here and try and turn it. And you can't. You might be able to, but you have to turn yourself because he's so tight to you. If you get all your weight over and you're over the top and everything. So what you do right here is you push your weight away. So you're at a 90 degree angle. Now there's no rolling or squirming about it. So here's going to be the first thing we do. I was kind of overreading the whole thing. First thing I want you guys to do is just knock the guy over to his hip, throw your arm deep, and drive forward to here. Okay, then I'm going to just have you sit through and use this hold about 3 or 4 times a piece. I'm going to walk around and watch, and then we'll break and come back. Learning to do this part, your leg position, your body position, and everything, the hardest part of this hold. You can learn this though, and we're going to spend some time on it. You can apply it to a lot of different ways to turn. Now, here's the thing I want you guys to concentrate on this one. A lot of people here where you can't turn, parallel to elevating the wrong leg with your leg. Just all kinds of problems. So this is my guideline.
Drive forward, sit under with your outside knee.
That's it. See, I pull them into my lap. That's the other thing keeping my body allows me to do. Watch what happens when I do this. See how his hip came up? Now I sit under. My other leg comes to the back.
Let's try it.
Now, I'm just going to show you a little bit of a different application. I'm going to re-explain the hold, show you a little different way to get into it, and let you work on it some more. I see a few problems. Still, one of the problems is that to start on this side of it, okay? So you're not able to get your arm deep from here, you're only able to get it this deep. Okay, so start on this side of it, and get it deep. Now, how many of you guys know how to do an ankle run? Good. Great way to get into this. Double leg, a counter to a switch, an ankle ride, a spiral ride, anything that you knock the guy down to his hip is a good way to get this hold. That's why it's such an effective hold. That's why it's so popular now in college level. One, refs don't stop it, okay? Refs are crybabies. That's rule one. So you gotta find moves that they don't stop. This is one of them. Two, the reason it's so effective is because it's so easy to get into. You fall into it all the time. You can double and throw them down. Great. Now, start here. You right his ankle like this. Okay? You throw your arm deep around his waist. So deep, in fact, your shoulder's right on his hip. This is important, so you have something to knock him over with. If I'm here driving, I don't have anything except my arm. If I'm here driving, I've got all the power of my legs and hips and everything right here. So I've just got his ankle and his hip. I drive, boom. And this position should look familiar. Some of okay. Now you just drive your legs in a circle again. See, I'm driving forward at the same time I'm circling my feet. Never letting him off his hip. Here I'm driving forward still. And now here's the problem. You guys are having a hard time getting their knee under this guy's hip. Or they're trying to put the wrong knee under. It's your outside leg that goes under his hip. And the way you get it under is by driving forward and picking his hip up, and then just sitting under. Now this position, perfect. See his knee? This is another problem. My knee is tight to his leg. Okay? It is not painful. So I keep a loose grip here. I can just grab a hold of the pocket. cup is on.